Hi, my name is Spencer Hinkle. I teach cabinet making at Portland Community College. And today I want to show you how to build this little tote box. It's a great project for cabinet making classes because we do a lot of different things, use a lot of different techniques, a lot of different equipment in the shop. But it's also a very versatile and very handy little box for anyone in the construction industry to have. I brought this one out because it's probably about 10 years old, so it's very durable. It's got little dividers in it, so it's great for putting things like screws or loom clamps if you're an electrician, or plumbing fittings if you're a plumber. Let me show you how it's constructed. Pretty simple. We've got a plexiglass lid, which is not absolutely necessary. You can do a plywood lid, but it's nice to be able to see what's in the box. And we have a handle, which is an 1¼-inch dowel. And then we have two sides, and a front and a back. And the thing I want you to notice about the front and the back before I take it apart is the back is full height. So these sides are 4 inches in height, and the back is 4 inches, but this piece is lowered so that the lid can slide across it. So there's one of our sides, and here's our other side, the back, and the front, and the bottom. So what we're going to be doing is cutting out these pieces. We'll be running some dados on a router table, and this one we'll be doing on the table saw. And we're going to be putting this radius and this angle on the front edge, and then putting it all together. Before we begin to cut our parts, I wanted to show you how we're going to do that. And you know, this is one of those things that comes with experience in planning how you're going to make your cuts. I've laid a sheet of plywood down here that I'm actually going to cut parts just like these out of, and then I've laid these on to show you where they're going to come from. So essentially I'm going to make a cut right down here. I'm going to make it oversized. We know these sides are 4 inches, so this is a total of 8. When I actually cut these in half, I'm going to need a little bit of room for my blade kerf. So, and I've got plenty over here, so I'm going to cut this at probably 9 inches. And I'm going to leave it intact. I'm going to go ahead and cut it to length, but I'm going to leave it at 9 inches so that when I run this through the router table, I've got a big piece to run through rather than a little piece like this that's going to want to rock and roll on me. So that's an important point that I wanted to make. And then I'll deal with these two parts separately. One last thing before I start cutting the material. Have you ever seen a board where the grain runs across the board? Probably not. And even though this is plywood, we want to make it look real. So we want to make sure that we have the grain running in the long direction. Okay, that's one thing you want to do. You're also going to find out if you do it the other way, when you go over to the router table and start routing these dados, you're going to get some heavy-duty tear out. So just wanted to make that point. And let's go ahead and cut these parts. I'm going to make my 9-inch cut first. All right, so now let's take this over to the router table and cut our dado. I've brought over the two example sides so that you can see how they're gonna lay out on this piece of plywood that we just cut. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna cut this back dado in the sides. But of course, they're still all in one piece and we'll ultimately cut them into their 4-inch widths. As I said earlier, it's much easier for us to run this big piece through than it is to run a little piece like this. It'll tend to want to rock on you. Now, you remember we talked about the material being 1/2 inch thick and then all of our dados and rabbets being 1/4 inch, half of that thickness. And let me show you how this router table is set up to do this. We have a router bit here, just a straight 1/4 inch bit. So the router bit is 1/4 inch in diameter. It's projecting out from the fence 1/4 inch, and it's up off of the table 1/4 inch as well. So no matter how we run this material through, we're always out 1/4, up 1/4. So let me go ahead and run this piece through and we will put the back dado in. There we have it. Let's go over to the table saw now and cut the 1/2 inch dado at the front of the box. This table saw is outfitted with what's called a stacked dado head. And what that means is there are several blades stacked up here so that we can get more width than just one blade. And I've adjusted this and set it up so that it's exactly the same width as our material. And there's a little dial indicator on the side here. Once you get it close, once you get, you know, the right sequence of blades in place, there's a little dial that you can turn and fine tune it. And it's just a matter of trial and error. You just have to run it a few times until it fits. And the best way to test it is to actually fit the piece in the dado and make sure that it fits. So I've done all of that, and our challenge now is to get the fence set the right distance from the dado head. We can't use the tape on the fence because these things have increased in width that no longer relates to the tape. So essentially what I am going to do is measure, get it close to where I think it needs to be, and if you look at your plans, it's 15.5 inches from the back of the box to the front of the dado. Set this at 15.5, and then I'm going to run a test piece through and measure it. It's exactly 15.5 inches, so we're ready to go. So there's our dado, and our material fits in there really nice and snug. It's just perfect. So now it's time to cut these parts down into their actual sizes, and we'll do that over at the other table saw.